Hello, kids.
Hi, Grandpa! What are we gonna learn today? We are very eager to learn.
Last week, we learned about unsung hero. How about one more today?
Yay! I've been waiting to hear more. Yes, and me too.
So who shall we talk about?
We want to hear about someone really unique.
Oh yes, this would be interesting. So here we go.
Someone unique? Did he come from space?
Ha ha ha. No, dear. Like all other unsung heroes who belong to our country, this superhero hails from Odisha.
Odisha?
Yes.
Grandpa, please tell us more about these real heroes. Please, Grandpa.
Definitely. You all need to know and learn about the battles you never read before and the heroes you never knew existed. Today we will learn about the youngest freedom fighter and martyr, Baji Raut, the brave son of Odisha.
Youngest? How young?
Just 12 years old.
Grandpa, how is it even possible? 12 years old and martyr? Please tell me more about this warrior.
Baji Raut was born on October 5th, 1926. At a village in Dhenkanal, Odisha. He was a board boy by profession.
He used to work at that age? Didn't he go to school, Grandpa?
No, dear. He had to earn to take care of himself and his mother. His father was a boatman who died when Baji Raut was an infant. After his father's death, the financial condition of the family worsened. His mother was ill and weak. She used to grind and husk the paddy in the home of the rich and affluent. But what she earned was insufficient to run the family. Baji Raut never had the opportunity to go to the school. Instead, he started ferrying people in the Brahmani River.
That's sad. A young lady working hard to meet the needs?
Yes, indeed. There is more to it. During 1920s, the British consigned few local zamindars and landlords to collect the taxes and perform other duties on their behalf in Odisha. With this, the growth and development of the local people worsened. They were not allowed to voice their opinion and their lands were grabbed. The poor suffered more and the feudal lord prospered. Baji Raut grew up watching the atrocities and oppression of the British, because of which he was very hostile towards them.
How can the British and the local heads act so rude?
True, Nanny. That is when, in 1938, the oppressed natives set up Praja Mandalas to raise voice against feudalism and the British. The British tried to curb the natives by imposing stern measures. They brutally tortured them and were jailed without any reason. Their meetings were banned. They opened fire on them, misbehaved with women, but the oppressed one did not give up.
Did not give up? Wow, anyone would be scared going through all this and they still fought?
Yes, they kept fighting the atrocities of the British and local lords exceeded brutality. The natives were ready to sacrifice their life fighting them.
Sad, but feels great to know how brave our Indians were.
So, now Baji Raut and many other natives joined the Praja Mandal group in Dhenkanal. Baji Raut and other boatmen became alert and kept a watch on the ghat as advised by the Praja Mandal members. They wanted to save the village on the other side of the bank from being plundered by the British. From 7th October 1938, Baji Raut kept a vigil by resting in his boat. Despite heavy rain, he didn't step back from his boat. On the night of 10th October 1938, Baji Raut parked his boat to a tree and rested. It was dark everywhere. In the wee hours of 11th October, the British man reached there. They woke him up and ordered him to ferry the boat other side.
Oh wait, did he ferry them? Did he, Grandpa?
No. He refused. They treated him, warned him. He resisted and didn't change his mind. Instead, he screamed at them and called them the enemies of the people. The furious policeman hit him on his head with the heel of his gun. The blow was so hard that his skull got fractured and he collapsed onto the ground. Blood was oozing profusely.
Oh no! What did he do then? Did he try to run away and save his life?
What? Run away? Will that ever happen with a superhero?
No!
Obviously. Instead, the little hero jumped into the river and called out loud, asking his friends of the Praja Mandal to come over. On hearing his scheme that echoed all over, they soon reached the spot. By then, the British themselves ferried a boat and left the place. That's it. Bajirao took his last breath on the river bank. India lost her youngest warrior.
We salute you, Bajirao. Jai Hind.
So, kids, now you know the role of Bajirao and the freedom struggle.
Yes, Grandpa, what a brave warrior he was.
Bajirao's patriotism, extraordinary courage and supreme sacrifice for our freedom is remarkable in the Indian history.
He is indeed inspiring. Grandpa, we would love to spend more time with you and listen more about real brave heroes.
I would love to. Next time I shall tell you about another superhero. Till then, take care, children.